Fox News alert and growing concern that the fighting between Israel and Hamas terrorists is a test run for an even bigger war that would pit Israel against the guns of Iran. Brand new hour here of America Live. Welcome, everyone. I'm Megyn Kelly. As we watch the rockets launching and the airstrikes go back and forth in the Middle East, we are being told that the country responsible for the long-range rockets raining down on Israel's cities is Iran. It's considered conventional wisdom that if Israel does go after Iran's nukes, Hamas would retaliate with rockets from Gaza. But Hamas cannot launch those rockets if it doesn't have them. National Security Correspondent Jennifer Griffin following these developments live from the Pentagon at this hour. Jennifer?
Hi, Megyn. Well, this conflict in the Gaza Strip needs to be seen in a larger context of Israel's concern about Iran. Here's U.S. the ambassador to the United States from Israel, Michael Oren.
Our problem is not our border with Gaza, but other countries' borders to Gaza and the access, as you said, of Libyan arms and arms that come from Iran through Sudan. Among the rockets being fired at us are the Fajr 5 rockets, which come directly from Iran. We know that Hamas terrorists have trained with the Iranians. There's a strong connection.
In the past few years, with the help of Iran, Hamas has been stockpiling these longer-range Fajr 5 rockets, which have a 75-kilometer range. Hamas and Hezbollah to the north in Lebanon have been proxy arms of Iran for some time. Israel has long known that if it participates in a strike on Iran's nuclear program, that Iran will use Hamas and Hezbollah to fire rockets into Israel. In a way, Israeli officials believe they will have to deal with the rockets from Gaza sooner or later, and it's likely they will send in ground forces so that these longer-range rockets will not be able to strike Israel down the road, according to some experts. The Pentagon is watching all of this very closely. For the first time, Hamas has fired rockets capable of hitting Tel Aviv and Jerusalem. They were provided by Iran and smuggled through the tunnels from Egypt through the Sinai Desert, which is easier to do since the Arab Spring and the removal of Hosni Mubarak. The Pentagon is also watching closely the performance of the Iron Dome anti-missile system that was developed with hundreds of millions of dollars of U.S. taxpayer money to help protect Israel. So far, it seems to be working pretty well. Since November 14th, the Iron Dome has intercepted 307 out of 875 rockets fired from the Gaza Strip. The Obama administration gave Israel $205 million to purchase additional Iron Dome batteries in 2010, and Congress recently approved an additional $600 million for the system, Megyn. Mm.